Thank you. You got to let it go on you. You got to let it go on you. You got to let it go on you. When it gon' let go, go. When it let go, you. When it let go, go. When it gon' stop to let go. To let it go.
So,
thank you.
Thank you. after snow is falling down, children laughing all around, lights are turning on like a fairy tale come true. Sitting by the fire we made, you're the answer when I prayed I would find someone, and baby I found you. All I want is to hold you forever, all I need is you more every day. You saved my being broken apart, you gave your love away, and I'm thankful every day for the gift. Watching as you softly sleep, what I'd give if I could keep just this moment. Time stood still, but the colors fade away, and the years will make us new. But baby, in my eyes, it's still the beautiful. All I want is to hold you forever, all I need is you more. You saved my heart from being broken apart. You gave your love away, and I'm thankful every day for the gift. All I need is you more every day. You saved my heart from being broken apart. You gave your love away. I'm thankful every day for everything.
We are gathered here today in the presence of God Almighty and all these witnesses to join together Stephen and Carla in the bonds of holy matrimony. Today we're going to witness the power of God's love and the miracle of the Holy Spirit to join two lives and make it one. Can you all join me in a word of prayer? Can we all bow down our heads before God? Lord, we want to thank you, Lord God, and even recognize your presence in our midst. We thank you, Lord God, because this is a holy day in your sight. This is the day that you have made. We will rejoice, we will be glad in it, Lord God. Because once again, Lord, we would witness, Lord God, your love, your grace that has overflowed, Lord God, over the lives of Stephen and Carla, and how that love is now being shared between the two of them. Thank you, Lord God, that is only made possible because you have filled their hearts with love. Lord, today, Lord God, we are doing this ceremony, Lord God, and we just recognize, Lord, that you are in the center of their relationship. You are in the center, Lord God, of the family that they're going to build. And most of all, you are here with us today. We want to honor you. We want to bless your name, God. Be glorified in everything that we're going to do today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, before we proceed with the ceremony, we'll just recognize the parents of the groom and the bride. And we're going to ask them if they are in agreement to give their blessings to their children today. So, Sir Alex and Ma'am Sen, are you in agreement to give your blessing? Parang nagmamadali ka din. Stephen, gusto ko na ipamigay. Okay. Are you in agreement to give your blessings to Stephen to be married today?
Yes po.
Yes na yes po.
Okay, in the same way, we would like to recognize the parents of Carla, Sir Bernard and Ma'am Bobet. In the same way, are you in agreement to give your blessing to Carla to be married today?
Yes, na yes, na yes, na yes, na yes!
Yes po.
Thank you. All right. Okay, having received your blessings from your parents, Stephen, do you take this woman to be your wife, to love her, to comfort her, honor her, provide for her, forsaking all others, cling only to her, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, for as long as you both shall live?
I do.
Carla, do you take this man to be your husband, to love him, submit to him, forsaking all others, cling only to him, for better or for worse, for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health, for as long as you both shall live?
Yes, I do.
Having said your I do's, Stephen, you may now take the hand of your bride. In Genesis chapter 2, verse 24, the Bible says, "For this reason, a man will leave his father and mother and be united to his wife, and they will become one flesh." And this is the word of God when he brought together Adam and Eve to be as one. In the same way that God is doing that, even in our midst today, putting you together, making your lives as one. Right now, we're going to join the couple in a time of worship before God. Let's just focus on God right now, and we're going to worship Him through singing. So please do join us, even as we just put God in the center and right in the throne in our midst.
Let's worship God. Lord, we acknowledge that You are the center of it all. You are the center of this wedding. You are the center, Lord, in bawat buhay na nandito, Panginoon. And we lift up everything to You, God, and declare that You are our God and Savior.
Jesus, at the center of it all. Jesus, at the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been You, Jesus. Jesus, nothing else matters. Nothing in this world will do. Cause Jesus, You're the beginning to the end, it will always
It's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, nothing else matters. Nothing in this world will do.
I'll say it out to God. Jesus, you're the center.
Jesus, you're the center. Jesus, you, nothing else matters, nothing in this world will do, oh, Jesus, Jesus, you're the center, everything revolves around you, Jesus. Center, it's all about you. Yes, it's all about you. From my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center. It's all about you. Yes, it's all about, sing it out. From my heart. Jesus be the center of it all. Jesus be the center of it all. And every knee will bow, and every tongue shall confess you, Jesus. Sing it out. Jesus, lift his name. Jesus, Jesus, Lord Jesus, 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 from my heart to the heavens, Jesus be the center, it's all about you. Jesus be the center of our lives. Jesus be the center of our lives. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus.
Join me in a word of prayer. Just bow your heads. Close your eyes. Lord, thank you, Lord God, because you love us so much, Lord, that you have rescued us, you've redeemed us, you've given us a brand new life, you've given us purpose, Lord. And part of that, Lord God, is having plans for us. And today, Lord God, we just recognize that over the life of Stephen and Carla. Thank you, Lord God, because this is part of your plan. Thank you, Lord, because you have gathered your people so that we could witness this, Lord God. That at the end of the day, your will, what you have planned, what you have set to do, Those are the things that matters the most. We honor you, Lord God. We give to you the center stage. We give to you everything. We offer to you everything that we're going to do today. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I'll invite Stephen and Carla to come here and take their seat. And I'll ask everyone to take your seat as well. Okay, good afternoon, everyone. If you're a family member of Stephen, could you just wave your hand? Okay, if you're a family member of Carla, can you also wave your hand? All right, if you're friends and churchmates of both of them, can you just wave your hand as well? Yon. All right, I want to welcome all of you this afternoon. It's an honor and privilege for me to celebrate this day with Stephen and Carla. And what we're going to do today is really just witness the goodness of God over their lives. And our prayer is that this would be a testimony for all of us. If you are married, okay, kung kasal ka na, may asawa ka, can you just wave your hand as well? All right. Okay, ulitin ko, parang nagkasikuhan pa yata yung iba. Tayo yon. Okay. If you are already married, can you just wave your hand? Yon. All right. If you are single and you believe that the day will come that you too will be married, okay, pwede bang kaway din? Okay, may mga gustong humabol. Ulitin ko, if you're single, can you wave your hand? Ayan, nakatingin sigad ha, so huwag kayong magreklamo. What we're going to do today will be based on the Word of God. And so can I ask the Bible bearer to bring the Bible. Lit. Sabi ko yung gamitin niya daw po, Maestro. Okay. Okay. Talaga na. Okay, lit nito ah. Okay. Stephen and Carla, I prepared a very quick message for you today. At the same time, if you're married, this will be a good reminder of the marriage vows that you also entered into when you yourself were married. And at the same time, that's the reason why I ask your status in life. If you are single, then please do listen to the Word of God as well. And my prayer is that it will inspire you to pursue God's will for you as well. There was a wedding mentioned in the Bible in Cana. And let me just read the passage. In John chapter 2, starting verse 1, on the third day, there was a wedding at Cana in Galilee, and the mother of Jesus was there. Jesus also was invited to the wedding with his disciples. When the wine ran out, the mother of Jesus said to him, "They have no wine." And Jesus said to her, "Woman, what does this have to do with me? My hour has not yet come." His mother said to the servants, "Do whatever he tells you." Now there were 6 stone jars for the Jewish rites of purification, each holding 20 to 30 gallons. Jesus said to the servants, "Fill the jars with water." And they filled them up to the brim. And he said to them, "Now draw some out and take it to the master of the feast." So they took it. When the master of the feast tasted the water, now turned into wine, and did not know where it came from, though the servants who had drawn the water knew, the master of the feast called the bridegroom and said to him, "Everyone serves the good wine first, and when people have drunk freely, then the poor wine. But you have kept the good wine until now." This is the first of his signs Jesus did at Cana in Galilee and manifested his glory, and his disciples believed in him. First miracle that Jesus did, and it happened during a wedding ceremony. And I believe that is not an accident. That's not even a coincidence. I believe that is part of God's plan to reveal that He is a God who really gets involved in the lives of His people. Getting married is a big decision that anybody makes. And yet God wants to be involved there. So three lessons, Stephen and Carla, that I would like to share to you and also for the rest of us. The first one is, well, Jesus was present. And I would like you to remember that, even as you are beginning to start a family, Jesus is present with you. What's important here is that the couple who are being married were not even mentioned. Hindi natin alam pangalan nila eh. But the story really centered on Jesus. And it made a big difference because Jesus was present during that time. And I believe that is your faith right now. That's why we're doing this. That's why we sang a while ago. That's why we started this ceremony by worshiping God. It's the heart to put God first and at the very center of your relationship. A lot of people are getting together today without the blessing of entering into a covenant of marriage. But you're doing a testimony actually. You're standing for what is right, asking God, Lord, be a part of what we're starting, even as a family. Diba? So marami ngayon, nagli-live-in na lang, okay na rin. Total, nagkaintindihan naman na, and they would do that. But the difference, the big difference is, you have invited the presence of God to be with you. So yun yung unang-una, huwag niyong kakalimutan yan, the presence of God. Jesus will be with you from this day on, till your last breath, and even for all eternity actually. So lagi niyong kasama si God. In your married life, there will be times that there will be disagreements, yung mga pagkakataon na hindi kayo magkakasundo. But that doesn't mean that God has left you. That doesn't mean that God has abandoned you. The presence of God remains. Which means you do your best to be reconciled with one another, to go back to the fold and be united. Remember, kayo yung magkakampi dito. Alright? So you are entering into a holy covenant. Kasunduan to sa Panginoon. So walang atrasan to. Okay? So yan yung mangyayari dapat. Ano yung presence ni Lord, lagi nyo dapat maramdaman. So kahit na anong paghihirap yung kaharapin sa buhay, tuloy lang. Nandyan si Lord eh. Kasama nyo siya. Which leads me to the second point. Because Jesus is present, well guess what? Miracles can happen. And that's what happened in the story that I read a while ago. There was a need. And yet, dahil nandun si Lord, the need was met. And not just the need, it even went beyond what is expected. Yung master ng feast nagulat eh. Ang sabi niya, usually, yung mumurahin muna na wine. Tapos, yung maganda muna na wine ang uunahin. Yung masarap. Tapos pag nakainom na, at hindi na gano'ng makakalasa na maayos, ilalabas yung pangit. And yet, sabi nung master ng ceremony, it's because it came from Jesus. They have kept the good, the best. And so, what does that tell us? You see, when you cry out to God, when there is a need, pag may pangangailangan, dahil nandun ang Panginoon, tutulong siya. And pag tumulong siya, you could expect beyond what your imaginations can come up with. Okay, so yun yung lagi nyo iisipin, na may mga miracles si Lord, may mga answered prayers. So pwede kayong umasa kay God. So let me just tell you, no, yung pinag-usapan natin, start dreaming together. Ano ba yung mga pangarap natin sa buhay? Ano ba yung gusto nyo ma-achieve? Even as you're starting a family now. Alright, ilang anak ba, Stephen? Yung tagal mo na sumagot dati. Lima, ang bilis mo. Okay. So alam yun, so limang anak. Alright, so yun, ano? So alam mo yan, yung lahat yan galing sa kamay ng Diyos yan. Again, ano, kahit ano man yung kaharapin sa buhay, whatever challenges, whatever problems that you may face, well, don't worry, God is present and miracles can happen. The last point is that wedding has become a place of faith and God was glorified. And so as you build your home, let it be a place of God's presence. Let it be a place where miracles are just common. But at the same time, let it be a place where your faith are growing every day. And it's growing together. So hindi lang yung isa yung malakas sa pananampalataya. Pareho kayo. And in times, may mga pagkakataon talaga bilang mag-asawa na yung isa yung mas malakas kesa sa isa. So what you do is the strength of one will be the strength of the other as well. When somebody is weak, then somebody can come in and bring in the strength. So, dapat united talaga. pati yung faith dapat sabay na nag-grow. So walang iwanan. So pag nag-dream kayo together, also dream about spiritual things. Set spiritual goals. Things that you could offer before God and He will be glorified. So yun yun, it's a place of faith. It's also a place where God is glorified. So let it be that, alam niyo, may dumalaw sa bahay niyo, they would sense the presence of God. At your home, pagpasok nila, mararamdaman nila, maaliwalas tong bahay na to. And the reason why is because God resides with you. And hindi naman malayo mangyari, Stephen and Carla, because you both love God. And so again, remember what you're doing today. You have invited the presence of God to be with you. He will guide you. He will lead you. He would bring you to even destinations that you have not even thought of. Miracles will happen. Keep on praying. Keep on believing. Make your petitions before God known, and He will answer them. And never limit God when He answers. Again, faith, and let God be glorified. All right? Can we all stretch out our hands towards Stephen and Carla, and let's just pray together. Lord, we stretch out our hands towards them because we believe, Lord God, that there are great plans that you have in store for the two of them, Lord God. Even as they're believing you, Lord God, for great things, Lord, you would surprise them with even more, Lord God. Lord, thank you, Lord God, because this wedding is already a testimony. The home that they have rented, Lord God, Lord, even the furnitures and the appliances that are there, Lord, ikaw lahat ang nag-provide nun. Lord, hindi pa nila nagagamit, and yet you have seen ahead of time and you have already provided. Let it be a reminder for them, Lord God, that you are God who comes through, that even before they open their mouths to ask, you have already given what they have need. What they need. In the same way, Lord God, I pray, Lord, that you would continually build their lives so that when people look at them, Lord, they would all be blessed. Ito pala yung ideal na mag-asawa. Ito pala yung itsura ng pamilyang binubuo ng Diyos. So God, our prayer is that you'd be the foundation and you'd be at the center of their very lives, Lord God. Lord, maraming salamat. Dahil today, Lord God, Lord, it's not separate lives anymore, Lord God. The life of Stephen, the life of Carla, Lord God, they are forever, Lord God, intertwined with you in the middle of it, Lord. Thank you, Lord God. We stretch out our hands to give our blessings to them. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. All right, I now invite Stephen and Carla to please stand up for the exchanging of the vows.
Hello, iba yung kopya, hindi joke. Love, my move. Where we are right now is something that is so unexpected. I wouldn't expect na I will meet someone like you as, you know, someone as amazing and as beautiful as you are. I'm so blessed that I'm about to get married to the one and only Carla Delia Ladrido Padilla. Na in a few moments, magiging Carla Delia Ong ka na. You know, this particular moment is a reminder how faithful, patient, gracious, and loving God is. You know, I desire to commit, and I desire and commit to be a husband and a father soon who will reflect and imitate the love of God as I have experienced His amazing love. Because of God's love, I will be the first to listen to you. Because of God's love, I will be the first to understand you. And maging patient din sa mga mood swings mo. Because of God's love, I will be with you in your lowest point. ang buhay mo. Because of God's love, I will be cheering for you at your highest and tell you how much I am so proud of you. Because of God's love, I will sacrificially serve you. Ako na maghugas ng plato. Wag lang yung mga tupperware na may mantika. So. Because of God's love, I will lead and build our family and have many children. Lima, di ba? Max, at max. Because of God's love, I will cover for you and defend you. Andito lang ako. Magamitin ko yung mga taba ko pang ano, depensa. Because of God's love, sasabayan kitang kumain ng okra at iba pang gulay. Makanggang dalawa lang kada araw na okra. So, because of God's love, paunti-unti, matatawa ka din sa mga jokes ko. No, I'm confident that this marriage will work and will last. Because God is with us. Kasama natin si God, hindi niya tayo papapabayaan. His love will abound in our family. Carla, knowing that it is God's will for me to marry you, I make a commitment to you today in the presence of our Lord and before all these witnesses, shout out po sa inyo, to love you with an unconditional love. I will be faithful to you always, never leaving you nor forsaking you. I will lead, guide, protect, and provide. Bibigay ko na ATM ko sa'yo. I will live with you with an understanding way, being thoughtful of your needs. I will honor you as a fellow heir of God's grace. I commit myself to fulfill God's plan for my life, to provide loving leadership and spiritual covering for you and our maximum of 5 children. I commit to co-labor with you in the building of the church and the advancement of God's kingdom until the day Jesus returns in all His glory. Amen. I love you so much. Ay.
Stephen. I love you. Every time I look at you, all I see is God's faithfulness and goodness in my life. My love, you are a testament of His overflowing grace and love for all of us, your family, for me. You're a testament. Who would have thought, diba, na dahil sa So Will I na story sa IG, it will bring us here together sa mismong kasal na natin. God is indeed a personal God who makes every love story unique for each of His children. And sobrang unique ng love story natin. And today, holding this truth that it is His will for me to marry you, in faith, honesty, and love, I make a commitment to you before God Almighty and before all these people to become your wife and helpmate in this lifelong union. Forever yun love, forever. Our marriage may not be promised with good times only, but with Jesus Christ at the center, I know that we will always get through. And this is all worth it. You are worth it. I choose you, and I promise to choose you as my husband every day we wake. Isama na natin yung paghihilik mo. I commit to love you with all of my heart, my strength, and my soul. And be there with you in the hills and valleys and every challenges that we will face in our life. I promise to laugh with you kahit minsan yung mga jokes mo, corny na. Pero tatawa pa rin ako, love. And even I promise to cry with you kahit na alam ko minsan ang babo lang ng luha ko and yun. Pero sasabayan mo rin ako at sasabayan din kita. I promise to grow with you and to worship and serve God with all of the days of our lives. And I promise to always protect and fight for our marriage and family. Yun nga yung 5 kids na maximum. And as the church submits to Christ, I commit to submit to you as the head of our household and my spiritual covering. I will always be here to inspire you, encourage you, and always support you in every way. Even yung paglalaro mo ng Switch. Pero ayun nga, may Switch. Ay, sorry, meron tayong screen time. Kasi maghuhugas ka pa ng plato, di ba? Chores first. And ayun, and I commit to co-labor with you in the building of the church and the advancement of God's kingdom until Jesus returns in all His glory. And I can't wait to witness more and more and more of God's plans and purposes for our lives together and as a family. And always know na sobrang mahal na mahal kita, Stephen Ivan Dangkaong. I love you so much.
Wedding vow is a very important part of the ceremony of wedding because they are making that not just to each other but even to God Himself. So hindi lang pangako sa bawat isa yan, pangako sa harapan ng Diyos mismo. We will now proceed with the changing of the rings. Can we ask the rings to be brought forward?
This ring is the sign of the covenant that I have made with you today to love you with an everlasting love as I place it on your hand and you receive it. You acknowledge that you are no longer your own but mine.
This ring is a sign of the covenant that I have made with you today to love you in an everlasting love. As I place it in your hand and you receive it, you acknowledge that you are no longer your own, but also mine.
Can I ask the coins to be brought in front? In Deuteronomy chapter 8, verse 18, the Bible says, "But remember the Lord your God, for it is He who gives you the ability to produce wealth, and so confirms His covenant which He swore to your forefathers as it is today. As Stephen and Carla will start their new life together as a married couple, they acknowledge that it is the Lord Jesus that will provide for all that they need and that they will honor the Lord with the first fruits of their wealth. Carla, that sign of that symbol of wealth that you are holding in your hands, you may now give it to Stephen. That is a symbol of you transferring the responsibility of providing to your spouse. Stephen, as you have received that symbol, you are making a commitment before God that from this day on, you would believe God for provisions for the whole family, that God would bless you with not just what you need, but the things that you desire as well, not just for your generation, not just for the two of you, but even for the generations to come. So Stephen, kaya pinasa sa iyo ni Carla yan. Ibig sabihin, in the sight of God, God has called you not just to be the leader of the home, but to be the provider, the reflection of God to the family that you're starting. So Stephen, ikaw yung magtatrabaho. At ikaw yung pakikitain ng pera ni God. Alright? So huwag mag-alala. Pag-praya natin si Stephen, can we once again stretch out our hands towards Stephen? Lord, we come before you and we are asking, Lord God, that you would see this man standing before you, God, starting his family. Lord, we talked about faith. We talked about miracles. And let it begin even right now. Give them a heart, Lord God, that is generous so that you could bless him, Lord God, so that he could be a channel of blessings as well. Lord, anoint the works of his hands so that whatever he touches, you would bless it, God. Lord, whatever he puts his mind to, Lord God, Lord, you would give him even plans and strategies, Lord God, so that whatever responsibility that is entrusted to him, he may be able to take it to the next level, Lord God, so that people around him would see that he is an excellent man. And Lord, by being that kind of man, I'm a man of excellence, a man of integrity, someone who fears the Lord and honors him, Lord, you would just bless him, Lord God. Not just spiritual blessings, but even physical blessings, Lord. Let wealth and riches come his way so that you could provide for the generations that would come through their lives. Lord, thank you, Lord God. Lord, bless this man. Bless the relationship. Lord, let it be, Lord God, that out of the family that you have started with them, Lord God, would come out generations, Lord God, who would be like-minded, Lord God, using the skills, the talents, the giftings to be a blessing to you and to others. And by doing that, Lord God, then treasures, riches would follow them, Lord. Bless them, God, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. I'll ask the couple to take your seat. Carla. We'll ask the veil sponsors to please come and put on the veil. Carla, the veil which covers your head is symbolic of your willingness to submit yourself to your husband and to acknowledge him as your spiritual covering. And Stephen, that veil on your shoulder serves to remind you of the cross and the altar on which the supreme sacrifice of God's divine love was offered. In the same way, love as Jesus loved his family, his church, by laying down his life. So Carla, over your head, kasi God has designed the family wherein the man is the leader in the home. That doesn't mean you are second rate in the sight of God. It's just the way God designed it. So Stephen, you are accountable before God. Ikaw yung leader na nilagay niya sa bahay. So every decision that you're going to make, you are making it not just for yourself or for your wife or for your family. Remember that you're making it in the sight of God as well. So work together, discuss things together, and once you make a decision, let it be a united decision na pag-usapan, na pag-prayan. Alright, so Stephen, ikaw yung leader. Okay, accountable ka kay God. So Carla, hindi ikaw yung leader, pero huwag ka mag-alala. Pag may pagkakamali, si Stephen ang mananagot. Okay. Can I ask the chord sponsors to please bring in the chord? The cord is a symbol of power, of the power of unity. The scripture tells us, though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken. So yung cord na yan, Stephen and Carla, represents your lives, yung buhay mo, Stephen, yung buhay mo, Carla. And the third strand is Jesus Christ himself. And just like the cord, your lives are now intertwined. So again, hindi lang kayong dalawa, kasama niyo si God sa relationship niyo, sa buhay niyo. We're now going to proceed with the communion. And at this time, si Stephen yung, at saka si Carla lang yung magko-communion. Communion is a very important part ng wedding ceremony. It's because even in the Old Testament, whenever the people of God would enter into a covenant, an agreement before Him, they would offer a sacrifice. So nagsasacrifice sila ng animal. And yan yung pinakapirmahan at yan yung nagsasabi na the covenant is in effect. So ang pirmahan sa langit is yung communion. All right? So praise God, hindi na natin kailangan mag-offer ng sacrifices ngayon. Jesus is the ultimate sacrifice. And so as you are going to partake the communion, remember, this is a covenant. Okay? Kasunduan sa harapan ng Diyos. This time, we'll ask for some of you to offer a prayer of blessing for Stephen and Carla, Pastor JC, Pastor Lee, and Miss Jinky.
Let's pray for Stephen and for Carla. Father, we thank you for this afternoon. God, we have witnessed your faithfulness over the lives of both Stephen and Carla. And God, even as we celebrate this memorable day, we recognize, God, that it's indeed your presence that has brought them together. And we pray, Lord God, that even as they start a brand new life together, our prayer is that you will be the center of their marriage. Lord, thank you, God, that you will be the builder of their home. And God, as you are the builder of their home, we are assured that your blessings, your favor, your grace will always be upon them. God, we declare fruitfulness over the lives of both Stephen and Carla. God, we have seen their individual lives, how they have been a blessing to many people. And God, that now that they are one, God, we could just imagine how you will use them together as a couple. We know, God, that many people will be blessed because of them. God, not just their family, but even the lives that you will entrust to them. So, Lord, I thank you that their lives will be dedicated unto you. That each time, God, that you will ask them to do something, their heart will be soft as clay, moldable, that they will be always ready to hear your word and obey you. Father, I pray, God, that their marriage will be a salt and a light to many people. God, not just students, not just families, but God, even people who are lost today. So, Lord, we thank you for Stephen. May you continually increase the mantle of leadership that you have given this man. But at the same time, for Carla, as you have called her to be the suitable partner for Stephen, God, I thank you that they will take it to heart that they are indeed one, one in spirit, one in soul. And God, knowing that they are inseparable today, God, we are just so excited in terms of where you will bring them together as a family and even as a couple. God, we declare your blessings, your favor to overtake them every single day of their lives, even their future children, God. Maraming maraming salamat in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, maraming maraming salamat sa araw na to na pinagkaloob mo. We are so privileged to be witnessing this union of Carla and Stephen. Lord, we just pray that you make them more deeply in love with you, God. That whatever problems they will encounter, they will just cling on you and to each other. And whatever decisions they will make, they will just depend on you and worship you in anything that they will do. Lord, individually they are not perfect, but because of you, you made this couple perfect for each other. And so, Father God, we just claim that you prosper their marriage and use them, Lord God, to be a testimony to other marriage couple, to other people who have plans to have to marry, Lord God. And we also pray, Lord God, that this is not the only day that we will be with them as their godparents, but we will be there. Use us, Lord, to be there with them, to support them, and to help them in any way that we can. Thank you, Father God, for this couple. We praise you. We honor you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Lord, we agree with all those prayers, and we pray for a greater fruitfulness in every area of their lives, in their marriage, in their five future maximum children, in their careers, in their ministry, and most important, fruitfulness in their individual relationship with you and as a couple. Lord, we pray, Lord, that they will experience fruitfulness, not just for them, but even for the generations to come. Not just for their own children, but for those that they will lead towards God. We thank you, Lord, that there will be a mighty flow of fruitfulness in their ministry and people turning to God because of this couple. Lord, I pray, Lord, that they will honor you in everything that they do. This may be a tall order for us individually and even as a couple, but we believe, Lord, that nothing is impossible with you. And as they remain in you, as they remain in the vine, that this marriage will be an example and a reflection of your faithfulness, your goodness, and your love in all of our lives. Lord, continue to be with them. As they start their marriage today, they will experience you every step of the way. We pray this in Jesus' name. Amen.
Thank you, Pastor Lee, Jinky, and Pastor JC. We will now proceed with the signing of the contract. We'll also ask the principal sponsors to sign. While the principal sponsors are still signing, we'll ask the core sponsors to please come in and take the cord. Can I call the veil sponsors to please come and take the veil? I'll ask the couple to please stand up. Instead of a unity candle, they're going to mix two colored sands together, and that would symbolize the mixing, the coming together of their lives. And that would be a unity sand. Even as sands when mixed together, cannot be separated, your lives won't be separated anymore. So Stephen and Carla, kahit na anong mangyari, wala nang hiwalayan to. All right? Go ahead. Okay, before we pronounce this marriage, can I ask the principal sponsors to please stand up? Mga ninong at ninang, maraming salamat po for standing with Stephen and Carla even as they embark on a journey with God to start their own families. And yung pagpili ng mga ninong at ninang, medyo mahirap po yan kasi ang dami nilang kakilala, ang daming mga kaibigan. But they saw something in you, in the way you handle and raise up your own kids and built your family. That's why they have chosen you. And my encouragement to all of you is that please keep on standing for them. Please be involved in their lives. So, kumustahin niyo po every time na maalala niyo silang dalawa, please do pray for them. And if there is a chance, please do talk to them. Kausapin niyo po sila, nakalima na ba talagang anak? Be involved more than the gifts that you bring or give to them. It's really prayers. When you lift them up in prayers, that makes a big difference in their lives. So please, kagaya nga ng tawag natin sa Filipino, di ba? Yung pangalawang magulang. So kayo po yung tumatay yung second parents ni Stephen and ni Carla. So again, maraming salamat for saying yes to them and being part of their families. Can we all give a clap din sa mga ninong at ninang? All right, thank you. You may now take your seat. Okay, can I ask the parents of Stephen to please stand up? Okay, I want to honor you before everyone else here. Bago po natin i-pronounce yung marriage, of course, we want to say thank you for the two of you for bringing Stephen into this world. Kayo po yung ginamit ni God para kay Stephen. So, Sir Alex, maraming salamat sa pag-suporta talaga kay Stephen. Lagi niya sinasabi, very supportive daw kayo. At sobrang yung anytime talagang willing tumulong. And naalala niya yung kahit yung ano yung pag-check nitong venue na to na from Canlubang to Mandaluyong to going here, tas balik na naman Mandaluyong, tas balik ng Canlubang. And yet wala siyang maririnig talaga na reklamo or excuses, and you're always there for him. So maraming salamat po Sir Alex dahil naramdaman talaga ni Stephen yung suporta nyo. Yung hindi lang sa oras, ano, even financially. So pinagyayabang ni Stephen. So talagang tumulong. Binawi na yata Stephen. So even in that area, you really helped him out. So maraming salamat po. And I was asking him, Stephen, ano ba yung naaalala mo sa father mo? And he recalled a time ng high school daw siya. Sabi niya ganun, talaga naaalala ko yung father ko, ano eh, yung si Papa, nung high school ako eh, tinawag kami yung magkapatid, tapos may pinapakita siya sa amin sa Bible, tapos may verse siyang tinuturo sa amin. And then sabi ni Stephen, hindi ko nga maalala kung ano yung verse na yun eh. But he saw something in you, something spiritual. There's the goodness of God in your heart. And so that has been an inspiration to him as well. I was wondering where this man got his love for God, and he would remember, yun nga high school daw siya. It didn't make sense to him back then, but it made an impact in his life. So whenever he would remember you, Sir Alex, naalala niya yun, yung time na yun, na may pinapakita ka, may binabasa ka sa Bible, ginather mo yung family just to share that. So thank you so much. And aside from that, yung pinaka-recent daw, nasa kotse kayo, sabi ni Stephen, sabi ng papa ko, basta, walang iwanan Stephen, lagi ako nandito, susuportahan kita. And so when I heard that, I imagined a man who really loves his son. So Sir Alex, maraming salamat sa pagpapalaki kay Stephen and being a man that he could see as a model even. So God bless you po, Sir Alex. Ma'am Sen. Thank you so much. Kasi tinatanong ko si Stephen, Stephen, ano yung naalala mo sa mami mo? Sabi niya, Doc June, sobrang dami. Tapos ano yun? Tapos ang tagal niyang mag-enumerate. Sabi ko, ang dami, wala kang maalala. Pero ang sabi niya, kasi si mama sobra. So the first description that came to his mind is sobra. Sobrang matyaga, sobrang mapag-alaga. Sabi niya ganun, naghintay ako ng something spectacular. Pero sabi ni Stephen, si mami constant lang eh. Araw-araw nandyan. Araw-araw tumutulong, araw-araw nag-aalaga. Sabi niya, hindi ka raw nagsasawang mag-alaga sa kanila. Kahit na malaki na, kayo pa raw po yung nagluluto at nagpupumilit na maglaban ng damit nila. So tuwan-tuwa naman si Stephen. Aside from that, yung pag may nakita kayong kahit konti lang na kailangan ng mga anak nyo, talagang always ready to help out. Sabi nga ni Stephen, kahit yung sirang wallet lang eh, next thing I know, binila na ako ni mama ng wallet. So kahit yung maliliit na bagay, hindi nyo pinapalampas. You're always there for him. And even when there was a time down na nag-work kayo, basta pag kailangan kayo sa school, kahit na umabsent, basta pag recognition day, may award si Stephen or may meeting with the parents, you always make sure na you're available for him. Hindi niya makakalimutan yon. And of course, kaya nag-gain din ng weight si Stephen. Masarap kayo magluto eh. Alam ko yan, nakatikim na ako ng luto niya. And sabi ni Stephen, si mama talagang sobrang hilig magluto. There was a time, na-discover niya yung celery. Lahat na niluto, may celery. Tapos minsan naman, cumin. So, eto naman yung flavor ngayon, puro cumin. Pero, sobra lang yung pag-aalaga. Sobra. But, one thing that he would always remember was when he graduated nung college. Tapos, kinausap niyo po daw si Stephen. Sinabi mo sa kanya, Stephen, I'm very proud of you. And when he heard that, something inside of him changed. Sabi niya, Doctor, mahirap i-explain, pero parang may nahil sa akin. And so, those are mere words, and I know you are encouraging your son and expressing your emotions to him. But God was doing something spiritual in his life. So thank you for standing with him and for him. And thank you, Ma'am Sen, for raising up a fine man like Stephen. Pwede ba nating palakpakan yung mami ni Stephen? Sir Alex, Ma'am Sen, thank you so much. You may now take your seat. Okay, yung parents naman ni Carla, please stand up. Sir Bernard, thank you so much. We have a brief conversation lang ni Carla. And ganun din, pinag-iayabang niya kayo. Magaling daw kayo eh, mag-ayos ng mga bagay. Kung kailangang mekaniko ng kotse, kayang-kaya niyong gawin. May sirang aircon, gagawin. Pero hindi niya makalimutan, yung bata daw siya. Tuwing uuwi kayo, mga 5 or 6 years old, may pasalubong daw kayo laging balot. So sabi ko, wow, okay, 5-year-old na paborito yung balot. So sabi niya ganon, lahat daw sila magkakapatid. Ever since that time, talagang looking forward na yung balot na iuuwi nyo. So tuwang-tuwa lang siya nung kinukwento niya yon. But what she would always remember is yung how you really took care of them. Kahit itong 2020 lang nung nagkaroon ng nag-quarantine, tapos nagkasakit sila, lahat walang makalabas ng bahay. And kayo daw po yung taga-labas talaga deliver ng pagkain, ng gulay, ng grocery. Kahit hindi kayo pumapasok, iniiwan nyo lang daw. And so you were always there for your family. And one time, tinanong daw kayo ni Carla, no? Yung and basta sabi niya ganun. Mahal ko naman kayo eh. Mahal ko talaga kayo. Mahal ko yung mami niyo, mahal ko kayo, kaya nga ako nandito. Kaya nga ako lagi nagpapakita sa inyo. And she would always remember that. And tuwan-tuwa siya kasi ang bilis daw, accepted kaagad si Stephen. Hindi daw siya nahirapan. At hindi niyo raw pinahirapan si Stephen. So accepted daw talaga. And so maraming salamat for that. And not only that, ano, yung talaga you went out your way daw po para makapag-prepare even for this wedding. And sabi ni Carla, pag naalala ko yung, ano, yung preparations ni Papa, yung mga ginagawa niya para sa amin, para sa wedding na to, sabi ni Carla, nakita ko talaga yung love niya for me. Na gusto niya maging party talaga siya ng celebration, ng milestone sa buhay ko. Sir, you are dearly loved by your daughter. So, mahal na mahal kayo ni Carla. And I know, mahal na mahal niyo rin siya. And yung love na yan, kita naman. That's the reason why he is able to trust a man like Stephen and love him. It's because that's a reflection of the relationship that you have with one another. So, Sir Bernard, maraming salamat sa pagpapalaki kay Carla. God bless you po. Okay, Ma'am Bobet. Eto. Pag mga nanay, iba talaga. Ano? So, si Carla, sobrang tuwang-tuwa talaga siya. Pinagyayabang kayo ng anak niyo, by the way. Pinag-usapan yung paglalaba, parang nagkaanuhan pa sila eh. Yung parang nagkakumperan pa eh. Kasi daw, kayo, talagang nag-i-insist kayo maglalaba ng mga damit. At ang dami niyong anak, ha? At malalaki na sila, pinaglalaban niyo pa rin. To a point na naawa na sila sa inyo, binilan na raw kayo ng washing machine. Pero, yun nga, sabi niyo raw, kasi exercise niyo yun. But more than the exercise really is the expression of love. And she would always remember that. Na, ano raw, pag nagtanong kayo, kumain ka na ba? Tapos hindi pa kumakain yung anak nyo. Nagagalit daw kayo pag nami-miss out yung meal time. Pag lumampas sa oras yung tamang pagkain. Nagagalit daw kayo at pinapagalit at sinasabihan nyo raw talaga sila. And she would always remember na pag meron daw may sakit or siya, pag may papakonsult, hindi daw kayo makakatulog talaga. At maya't maya, nag-check daw kayo, nangangamusta. Sobrang yung pagmamahal na pinakita niyo para kay Carla. And kahit ang dami niyo daw, anak, pantay-pantay daw. So, nung narinig ko yun, grabe, believe ako sa inyo. Some parents would have favoritism, di ba? Yung may mga favorite. Pero lahat daw sila favorite niyo eh. So, sabi ko, paano ba kayo nag-spend time ng mama mo? Saan ka ba niya niyayaya? Sabi niya, Dok Shu, minsan pag magpapapedicure, manicure si mama, ako kasama. Pero hindi lang siya exclusive, yung iba rin daw niyong anak. So again, pantay-pantay niyo silang tinrato lahat. And that is remarkable for a big family. So marami po silang magkakapatid, ano, if you don't know. Ilan po ba? 10 po ba? O basta? 19. Okay, tumawad pa ako. Okay, 19 pala. So 19 yung inalagaan ni Ma'am Bobet. So Ma'am Bobet, marami pong salamat sa pagpapalaki kay Carla. Sobra lang po talaga yung pagmamahal na galing sa inyo. God bless you po. So, Sir Bernard and Ma'am Bobet, maraming salamat. You may now take your seat. Oh, sorry. Can we all stand up pala? So, okay, please. Kinakabahan si Stephen. Having pledged your faith in God, and your love for one another by exchanging of the vows and the giving and receiving of the rings and looking to heaven and asking divine sanction, I now pronounce you man and wife. What God has joined, let it forever remain sacred, because you are now husband and wife, one in spirit and soul, standing pure and holy before God and one another. And Stephen, because you have taken on the responsibilities of a husband. Stephen, you may now kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, I now present to you Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Ivan Ong.
Thank you so much, Pastor June. Thank you po. Congratulations again, Stephen and Carla. Let's give it up for Mr. and Mrs. Ong. All right, so the newlyweds would like to say a few words to their friends who also joined this wedding celebration online. So this is your chance, Stephen and Carla.
Shout out po sa mga team online. Mga relatives po namin na from other nations, iba't ibang bansa po. Thank you so much po for joining. Thank you po sa mga nasa Facebook Live and sa mga estudyante na kasama natin ngayon. So thank you sa inyo and to my ministry partners. Thank you so much for joining today. So kanaman lang.
Sobrang thank you po. Thank you po sa mga support niyo po sa amin ni Stephen, even online lang po, and hindi po kayo nakapunta dito sa mismong venue po namin, pero sobrang thankful po kami sa inyong lahat, and alam po namin na you are celebrating with us, and thank you din sa mga prayers po and mga message niyo po sa amin. We love you po.
Thank you, Stephen and Carla. Now at this juncture, we will now have our photo op. Okay, starting with, of course, Mr. and Mrs. Ong.
I can't wait to live my life with you. I can't wait to start. You and I will never be apart.
Okay, so while the photographer is preparing the setup, entourage, guests, and family, please stick around. And we will just call you guys if it's your turn already. Okay, thank you. May we invite Pastor June to join the bride and groom for the photo op po. Ladies and gentlemen, we do have a kakanin bar at the back, so you can enjoy that while we do our photo op. And there's also a photo booth to mark this special occasion, so you are most welcome also to enjoy that one. All right, next up, may we invite both parents of the bride and groom to join them on stage for their photo op. And also, ladies and gentlemen, if you will be posting pictures and videos, please use the official hashtag He Stephen to Carla's Heart or hashtag Ang Nakarlaan kay Stephen. Again, that is hashtag He Stephen to Carla's Heart and hashtag Ang Nakarlaan kay Stephen. Thank you. Thank you. The parents of the brides, stay na lang po tayo for your photo op po, sir. One more po. May I ask also the siblings of the bride to please prepare? You will have your photo op after this one po. So may we invite the siblings of the bride to join the bride and groom and also their parents on stage for their photo op. Please stay. Now may we invite the relatives of the bride to also join them on stage for your photo op with the newlyweds. Relatives of the bride, cousins, nieces, nephews. Again, ladies and gentlemen, we have a kakanin bar at the back.
Dreamed of this a thousand times.
Entourage, please do stick around for your photo op with the newlyweds. Thank you so much. Now may we invite the parents of the groom to join the newlyweds on stage for your photo op. Again, if you are uploading videos and pictures, don't forget our hashtags. Hashtag He's Stephen into Carla's heart and hashtag Ang Nakarlaan kay Stephen. Parents of the groom po. Okay, may we ask the siblings? May we ask the sibling of the groom to join them on stage? Sibling. Okay lang yan. To the relatives of the groom, please stand by. It will be your turn after this picture pop. Please stay. Now may we ask the relatives of Stephen to join him and his lovely bride for your photo op. Principal sponsors, you will be up next. You ran your finger down my back and you spelled out your name. While we lay there on the soft warm ground for a week and 13 days. And I know that it's thank you, everyone. Now may we invite the principal sponsors to join the bride and groom for your photo op with them. We have a kakanin bar at the back. We also have a photo booth for you. Thank you so much. Male principal sponsors, please stay. And then female principal sponsors, can you please stay here at the side, and then you will go up again po. Thank you so much. Ayan. On stage. Nandito na po siya. groomsmen, groomsmen, secondary sponsors, you are needed here on stage for your photo op. May we also invite our principal sponsors to join us here on stage? Again, calling our principal sponsors. Thank you, guys. Now, may we invite the principal sponsors and the parents of the bride and groom for another photo op with the newlyweds. Of the bride and groom, please join them on stage, po. Principal sponsors po. Yes po, principal sponsors and parents of the bride and groom. Okay, so may we invite naman the grandmother of the bride together with her titos and titas for their photo op po. Okay, so we have another request. May we invite the cousins of the groom to join us here on stage for your photo op with the newlyweds. Again, may we invite the cousins of the groom to join us here on stage for your photo op with Mr. and Mrs. Ong. Thank you, everyone. All right, so may we invite this time the cousins of Stephen on the mother's side. Relatives. Relatives of Stephen on the mother's side. Kindly make your way here on stage for your photo op with the newlyweds. May we invite the titos and titas of Stephen. Thank you. wait lang. Okay, Carla and Stephen, quick lang. Can you wave for 5 seconds here sa camera na to? Okay, Carla and Stephen, can you just wave for 5 seconds and then kiss ng 3 seconds? Okay, here. Here sa camera na to. Okay. So last na lang po, friends from HG Silos. It's your turn. Once again, may we call on their friends from HG Silos for your photo op with the bride and groom. Alright, so that concludes our photo op with our newlyweds, Mr. and Mrs. Ong. Friends of the bride and groom, don't worry, you will have your chance later, okay? We will call you on stage to have your photo op also with the bride and groom. Alright, thank you everyone. All right, so again, we have our kakanin bar at the back, and also we have our photo booth at the back. Those are all yours to enjoy. And ladies and gentlemen, I am Yamsi Manongdo, and it is my honor to be one of your hosts for tonight's wedding reception.